I'm Maria, and today I am going to show you how to fix the server IP address could not be found error. In this video, we're going to show you how to resolve the server IP address could not be found error. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, let's fix the server IP address could not be found error. I recommend running through this list in order. Check your internet connection and router. Restart your computer. Use an incognito or private browsing window to navigate to the site. Set the browser to open pages in a new tab or window. Disable your virtual private network or VPN and antivirus software, and reinstall your browser. If you still get the error after checking all of these, you'll at least know that your computer and connection are both in optimal states. Now, on to the next fix. It's a good idea to clear your browsing data as a second step because it could get rid of any older cookies, settings, and other cached data that could impact your browsing experience. Throughout this video, we're going to show you fixes in both Windows and macOS, where the processes may differ. For Windows, you'll use Microsoft Edge, and for macOS, we'll use the fantastic Brave browser. Starting with Brave, you'll head to the hamburger menu in the toolbar, then to More Tools, then Clear Browsing Data. For Edge, you'll need to open the hamburger menu and navigate to the settings screen. Then, you'll want to open the left-hand hamburger menu and choose Privacy, Search, and Services. Brave will pop up a familiar screen where you'll select the data you'd like to clear and click the Clear Data button. However, for Edge, you'll need to scroll down to the Clear Browsing Data section, then click the Choose What to Clear button. This will pop up the same type of menu as Brave. Regardless of the browser you use, you'll want to clear out your browsing history, cached images and files, and cookie information. However, feel free to delete more here, as there will be no harm in doing so. Once you confirm, your browser will clear out the data you specify. From here, check for the error and take a look at some of the other methods if this doesn't work. Given that there's a potential issue with a DNS lookup service finding a relevant IP address, it makes sense that you also flush out your own DNS cache. Check out our guide on how to do this by checking out our resources below. This will refresh it and remove the server IP address could not be found error to boot. Note that you'll need to use either the terminal on macOS or the command prompt on Windows in order to do this. From here, you can begin to look at specific settings for your proxy server, IP address itself, and more. For macOS, head to System Preferences, then Network screen, then click the Advanced button in the lower right-hand corner. Here, navigate to the Proxies tab, then untick everything in the left-hand list. You'll then want to confirm with the OK button. For Windows, navigate to the Network and Internet screen using the Windows search bar. Then click Proxy from the left-hand sidebar. Next, scroll down to the Manual Proxy Setup section and toggle the Use a Proxy Server button to off. While you might want to restart your computer for extra confirmation, this should turn off your proxy settings and let you test for the server IP address could not be found. Sometimes you'll want to refresh your IP address altogether. This is called release and renew and doesn't take much effort on either Windows or macOS. For Windows, it's an extension of the approach to flush your DNS. This time, you'll use the command prompt to enter three commands one at a time. For the Mac, you'll head back to the System Preferences, then Network, and then Advanced screen. This time, you'll select the TCP/IP panel. Within this screen, click the Renew DHCP Lease button. You might not see a success message on macOS, but the button will carry out the action you want. After this, if you still see the server IP address could not be found, you can also update your DNS address and server. Some like to use a solution such as Google's public DNS or Cloudflare's offering. Regardless of which DNS address you want to use, there are different approaches for Windows and macOS. For Mac, you'll once again head to the System's Preferences, then Network, then Advanced screen. You'll want the DNS tab here. You'll use the plus button for the DNS servers section to add your public DNS address. Once you do this, confirm your changes. For Windows, go to the Network and Internet screen again and choose the Ethernet link from the sidebar. Here, you'll want to choose the Change Adapter Options link. Next, right-click on your connection and choose Properties, Within the pop-up window, choose the Networking tab, then either the Internet Protocol version 4 or Internet Protocol version 6 entries and click the Properties button here. On this next screen, you'll enter your public DNS address under the Use the Following DNS Server Addresses radio button. Once you enter and confirm your changes, check for the server IP address cannot be found error and move on if you have no success. This method to fix the server IP address cannot be found problem is likely the most complex on the list. You'll use a command line editor called Nano to alter your host's file and either add or remove the IP address for the site in question. The first part of this approach involves finding the IP address for the site. To do this, head to a DNS lookup site, such as What's My DNS? Here, search for your site's A record and note the IP address that's most common from the list of propagated addresses. Next, you'll want to access and edit the host's file. However, Windows and Mac both have different ways to do this. The goal is to either remove the IP for the site if you find it within that file or add it if it isn't there. Either one could both cause and fix the server IP address could not be found error. So try them out. However, once you confirm that this step doesn't work, make sure you revert the file back to how you found it. This will stop errors from cropping up in the future. Windows users have an etc. folder that will sometimes contain unnecessary files within. As such, you'll want to remove them to see if this resolves the server IP address cannot be found error. Within a Windows File Explorer, head to the C drive, then Windows, then System 32, then drivers, then etc. Make sure you back this folder up before you select everything within and delete. A quick solution to the server IP address cannot be found error. However, you might also want to try putting the files within the etc. folder back one at a time. Once the error reappears, you can discard that particular file and get back to browsing the web. We have another Windows-specific resolution to the server IP address could not be found error. This time, you'll restart the DNS client services, crucial for domain name resolution and caching. To do this, search for services using the Windows search bar. Within the list that shows up, you'll see the DNS client service, and you'll right-click it and select Restart. However, in some cases, you'll see an error when you try to do this. An alternative approach is to open a command prompt window and run the following commands one at a time. You might even see restricted access here too, in which case you'll need to skip over this solution and try the others on the list. The final step is to update the drivers for your network adapter. Mac machines don't let you update the drivers from their interface, so there's a different approach. Within the System's Preferences, then Network screen, highlight your network within the left-hand column, then click the minus icon to remove the network in its entirety. Once you remove the network, restart your machine, head back to the network panel, and this time click the plus icon to add your network again. For Windows, you'll want to head to the Device Manager screen using the Windows search bar and carry out the following. Within the Network Adapters section, expand the list. Right-click your adapter and choose the Update Driver option. You'll want to carry out an automated search for the driver. Once this process completes, restart your computer and check for the server IP address cannot be found error. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%. And you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. We offer 2 months free with any annual plan, a 30-day money-back guarantee, and unlimited free basic migrations from any host. Head over to kinsta.com/plans to get started. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.